Today's video is all about scope boxes in Revit. I'm going to be explaining what are scope boxes, how to set them up, and I'm also going to be sharing some tips and tricks along the way. Let's go. Now, scope boxes are Revit elements that allow you to control the scope of certain Revit elements. So one of the main uses of scope boxes is to connect them with the crop view region. So you can create a scope box that encompasses the whole building or part of the building, and then you can basically assign it to all of the floor plan views, all of the sections, all of the elevations, and then they will all be cropped to the scope of that box, so you don't have to adjust each crop one by one, and you can make modifications to all crop regions at once. Additionally, you can use scope boxes to adjust datum elements. So these will be grids and levels. So you can create a scope box that goes around your entire building, and then all of the levels and grids will basically kind of follow the extents and will not go past that scope box. So you can easily control all of these datum elements through one kind of graphically adjusted box. Now, quickly before we jump into Revit and I show you how to use the scope boxes in action, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So if you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content where I explore all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are at my office building project. And first, I'm going to be showing you how do you actually create a scope box. So unfortunately, at this moment, I cannot create a scope box because if I go here to the View tab and then go to the Create panel, you can see the scope box is grayed out. We cannot create scope boxes in 3D views. We can only create them in plan views, like floor plan views or reflected ceiling plans. Now, to create a scope box, now you can see it's no longer grayed out and I can click here. You just click and basically the command is started and it works like any other rectangle that you might be placing in Revit. You just need two clicks to place it. Now, you might want to adjust the height here. Now, if you're using previous versions of Revit, so Revit 2023 or older, the height parameter can only be numerically adjusted over here. So be careful about that and set it up here to what you like. Because I'm using Revit 2024, I no longer have that constraint and I can adjust this numerical value whenever I want, so I'm just going to leave it as is. So in this case, let's say I want to create a scope box around this structural core of this building, so kind of the reinforced concrete walls. So I'm just going to click once here, drag it out, and then click once again here, and I have my scope box. Now, this scope box is still selected, so I can go here to the name and I can call this one scope box dash structure, for example, because this is a structural core. Okay, so now we have that scope box over here. So what do we do now with this scope box? Well, let's say I want to create a set of views for this particular structural core and I only want to present this part of the drawing. Well, what can I do now is go here to the first level floor plan in the project browser. I can right click and then I can go to duplicate view, and I'm just going to be duplicating this as a dependent, just like that. So we have this duplicated view, and I'm also going to just rename it to a level one structural core. Okay, so once we have created this new view, what I can do now is go here to the view properties. I can scroll down to extents. You can see that the view is already cropped like so, but what I can do is go here to scope box and then I can set this to scope box structure, hit apply, and now it basically reduced the crop of that view down here to, basically the extents of our scope box. Now I can do this for the rest of the views. So I can duplicate my level 2 floor plan and do the same thing. I can do the same thing for the roof or the underground level. Now, speaking of all of these other levels, it might be time to actually adjust our height of the scope box. So if I go back to the 3D view, we can see that I have created this scope box here and it's visible. It's like this green dashed line. But what you'll notice is that here at the first level, it's going to be basically aligned with that first level because we have created it at level 1. It's going to just start from level 1 and then it goes up from there. So in this case, if I want to encompass the rest of this building, I can just drag out this bottom part and I can kind of take a look here and I actually want to go past the foundation just like so. And then here, if I don't want to go too high up above the roof line, I can adjust that as well. Also, you can adjust it from side to side, so just like this if you want, but in this case, I don't want that. And the only reason why I did this is so I can show you when you go back to the floor plan, you can see that here the crop of that view has been extended because the scope box now controls the crop because we have assigned that here in the view properties. Now keep in mind that when you assign the extents or the crop region of the view to a scope box, you can no longer adjust it. So we cannot really turn it off until we unassign it by setting to none. In this case, I don't want that, so I'm not going to change that, and I'm just going to go one step back just so I can fix the change that they have made here. Now, speaking of scope boxes, you can use them for sections as well. So here, if I go to first level floor plan and I decide to open up this section, I can just go to the section, go down to extents, and then I can set this to that scope box structure. So it's going to reduce the view to this crop. Now here we can see all of the annotation and I can fix that by turning on the annotation crop. So now it's going to eliminate any annotation elements outside of our scope box or outside of our annotation crop. We can actually adjust that and move it wherever we like. So that's basically how this works with our sections. Now you can also use scope boxes in 3D views such as this one. So let's say I want to create a 3D section of this part of the building. I can just go here to the properties, scroll to extents, find the scope box, and then I can set it to scope box structure and hit apply, and it's immediately going to create a section box that's going to grab that part of the building. Now, what they don't like here is the fact that, well, it doesn't really cut in. So it only shows you kind of the exterior of it, which will be useful in a lot of cases. But if you want to have kind of a nicer section, well, it doesn't work for that. But this can prove useful in a lot of cases. Okay, now let's take a look at how scope boxes control the datum elements. First, I'll show you an example of these grid lines here. So we have our grid lines, and what I can do is I can select all of the grid lines in this view. I'll go to filter, check none, and then I'm just going to select the grids. Apply. Okay. So now with all of the grids selected, I can go here to the properties and under extents, we have the scope box and I can set it to our scope box structure. As soon as I hit apply, we're going to get an error warning, actually 6 of them, saying that here we have an issue because our scope box is located here. And we actually have, well, 1, 2, 3, 4 of these grid lines going through that scope box, and the rest of them don't really intersect with the scope box at all. So obviously the scope box cannot affect the grid lines that are not intersecting with it. So it's going to give us an option to disassociate those grid lines. And as you can see now, only these grid lines that go through the scope box are limited to the extents of this scope box. Now, in this case, this doesn't really work very well, so I don't recommend using these scope boxes in original views. Already when you create a scope box, it is going to trim everything kind of when you adjust the crop. So in this case, where we want to kind of show a smaller segment of the model, it is going to work and it is going to give us the datum elements or the grids set here. However, don't then do that adjustment here in the larger views where you have the whole thing. So in those cases, what I would do is I would have one scope box around the entire model. So to show you just how that works and just to demonstrate how scope boxes affect the levels, I'm going to create a new scope box that goes all the way around this building, just like so. And then I'm going to call it the levels scope box. Click apply. And now when we go to the 3D view, we have this. I'm just going to turn the scope box here to none for this view and turn off the section box. Okay, so this is what we have. And then I can adjust the scope box just to go to the bottom here of the building. Perfect. And now what I can do is I can select all of the levels just like this. Go to filter and check levels only, hit apply. Okay, so now once the levels are selected, in the extents, I can adjust the scope box, set it to the levels scope box. And now what you'll notice is that the levels will kind of reduce or come to that scope box. And now if I move the scope box, the extents of those levels will move with that scope box, and this will also be reflected in any elevations or sections that you have. So this is a really nice way to control the extents of your views with an additional scope box around your model. Now at this point, our model is starting to look kind of chaotic, and it might not be the best idea to show all of these scope boxes everywhere. So luckily, when you go pretty much in any view where you select the scope box, you have the views visible option, and this allows you to adjust the graphics of the scope box. Well, to be more exact, it allows you to override the visibility of the scope box in all of the views. So here, for example, if I don't want to see the scope boxes in my 3D views, I can just come here to these 3D views and set it to invisible. So basically, this scope box will no longer be visible in any of the views where I have turned the visibility off. So now if I go back to the 3D view, the smaller scope box is no longer visible. Now, also speaking of the visibility of scope boxes, they will not print by default. So here, if I want to print this, or if I want to export to a PDF, for example, when we get the settings, what you'll notice is that hide scope boxes option will always be checked on as default. So if you want to see the scope boxes when printing your drawings, you want to uncheck this field. I usually tend to leave it on because usually scope boxes are something that you use kind of to make your workflow a little bit easier, and it's not something that's going to be adding to the design and something that's necessary to be there on the drawing itself. Finally, I want to show you how scope boxes can be used to help us with rotating some of our views. So here in this case, we have this building, and let's say we have this annex, which is at an angle, and I want to represent only this part of the building. So for that, I would use a scope box. I would go here to the view tab, to the scope box, and then for the scope box, we can only really create it as a rectangle. However, we can rotate that scope box. So if I select it, I can rotate it here by clicking and holding and rotating. Or something that I find a little bit more precise is to go to the rotate tool. RO is the shortcut. I like to place the center of rotation somewhere where I have a line at the angle, start from the horizontal, and then end up here, just kind of attached to this line. And now we have this scope box, which I can actually adjust the extents off, just like so. And then we can now rotate this view according to the scope box. So we have the scope box, let's call it, scope box 3. That's perfectly fine. And now if I go here to the properties panel and find my extents for this view, I can just set this to scope box 3, hit apply, and it's just going to automatically rotate our view to show this particular annex of the building. So this is just some additional part of the scope box functionality. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page, which I'm going to be linking up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.